This is Dr. Marathi here. So this video is regarding the preparation for exam. Now most of you have a question how to prepare for exams. So which exams I'm talking about here? I'm talking about the mainly krok as well as the exam ifom. So most of you are like having the dilemma where to start from. So mostly I'm getting the question where to start from, what to study, right? And how much to study and which are the things to follow, which not to follow. So most of you are confused. So let me clarify, the students who are writing the exam ifom 1 as well as krok 1. So these are equivalent to a step 1 level of examinations. So what do you mean by step 1 level examination? All these are preclinical subject included, right? So in this preclinical subject, see, we have some subjects where you need to remember the facts. Yes or no? We have some subjects we need to understand. We have some subjects we need to understand as well as to remember. So do not get panicked anytime when you're preparing for the exam, especially any subject when you're preparing. Have a clear-cut idea what topics you're going to study. What topics you're going to study, and that's what is most important. What topics you're going to study and how will you utilize them. Now, when I'm talking about KRO, most of you, 9 subjects are there where to start from. So where to start from, this is my idea. All of you are in third year, you have good, if you don't have good basics also, you'll have a basic idea about the physiology. Start from physiology. Why I always advise start from physiology, do not start from anatomy. The only reason is, anatomy is a subject where you need to spend time. But physiology, once you understand, that will serve you for the solving the questions of other subjects like pathophysiology, like pathomorphology and pharmacology. So that was the only point I always recommend you to start from physiology. Now once you start with physiology, see, physiology is a subject where you need to know a lot of things. So for that purpose, you need to pay attention to the few systems in the physiology. Only very few systems. For example, let's take cardiovascular and adrenal. These are the most two important physiologies you should have for your krok exam. But physiology is not like that. You need to have other things also, basics. And most of you have a problem with my subject, which I teach, pharmacology and pathology. Well, guys, pharma is not a subject where you will go saying that, okay, I will mug this up and I will go there. Please do not do the big mistake mugging up pharma always. I recommend you to remember the drugs. I agree, you need to mug up the drugs. It's not about mugging up. Please do understand the mechanism of every possible drug. Without knowing the mechanism, you will not be able to solve the question. Because past 3 years of my experience in teaching krok exam, believe me, that krok exams questions were like very simple, but they were all questions based on the logic. So they had some logic in them. So without knowing logic, if you're just going remembering the drugs, that's not gonna help you. That's the first thing. Second thing, pharma don't directly solve the question. That's the second thing. If you start solving the questions directly, you're gonna get into a problem. You'll not be able to understand anything. So do the topics for pharmacology and pathomorphology, pathophysiology. These subjects, see, these are way too big subjects. So if you are unable to do everything, but do some concise topics like general pathology in both pathomorpho, in pathomorpho point of view, try to learn about your inflammation, how to differentiate between the benign and malignant tumors, learn about the hypersensitive reactions, learn about the cell adaptation. If you know these topics which I told now, it's gonna serve you like more than 1/4 of the pathomorphology. If you have these basics and apply this one, you'll be able to solve every question. Because when pathomorphology, all of a sudden some new question pop out, and you don't have to be scared, because that needs to be understood. There is an understanding in pathomorpho. Please do that. So do not waste your time mugging up all the previous year question. That's gonna be the stupidest thing which we can do, by mugging up the previous year question. So there are some wrong questions or something like that you can mug up, but not everything you sit and mug up saying that pathomorpho is all about words, remembering them. No, pathomorpho is not about words. Please learn the topics. There are some topics in infection diseases, learn those infectious diseases like typhoid, learn the anthrax, learn meningococcal scarlet fever, all the infection diseases. And you need to learn about how to differentiate between benign and malignant tumors. It's going to be a very small table. If you learn that, that's more than enough. And for the pharmacology, you need to have few topics very, very clear. And for the list of topics, for example, if you're confused, if you don't know which topics to prepare, you can contact me. I will help you with the list. Now the next thing, and we are done with the third year subjects. Let's come back to the second. So physiology is the most important thing. And microbiology, keep it for the end. Keep it for the end means, so when you're going for any exam, microbiology is a subject where you need to remember thing. So do one thing, prepare microbio 1 month before the exam. Just remember microbio, go vomit it in the exam, replicate the same thing in the exam, come back at first.